In our last episode, we learned about intuitivity in disabling and enabling front panel objects with property nodes, as we see here. These front panel objects being disabled or enabled with these property nodes. At the end, I asked if there exists an easy way to modularize what I've done and access the same disable properties on all these objects without creating separate property nodes for each object each time I enable and disable. That's what we really want, and that's what we'll do now. First, we'll look at how we previously accessed the disable property through these implicitly linked property nodes. Why are they called that? To differentiate them from explicitly linked property nodes. Well, what's that? I can create an explicitly linked property node by simply pulling up a generic property node. This property node can display the properties of any object. It just needs to be pointed to that object. We do that by creating a reference to an object. Let's do that. We'll copy these controls to a new VI. Control N is a shortcut. I'll right-click on Acquisition Rate and choose Create Reference. Now, I'll pull up that same generic property node and wire the reference into the reference input. Now I've exposed all the same properties of the object with this explicitly linked property node as I had with this implicitly linked property node. The object is the acquisition rate control. This property node is explicit because I use this reference to explicitly point it to a particular object, and has the added benefit of not needing a parental advisory. So why would I want to be so explicit? Let's examine. There are many reasons. A common reason is to have a single property node access the same property of multiple objects. We have a perfect need for an explicitly linked property node in our current test VI, as these three implicitly linked property nodes here and here are accessing the disabled property on three different front panel objects. These three. If I want to use one generic property node on these other two objects, I'll need to create references for those. How can I have this same property node access these references? Simple. Create an array and auto-index it into a for loop. Now choose the disabled property. Change to right. Move this over. Create a constant. Now if I pull up my front panel, and put this on highlight execution, I can watch as one by one I will disable each object. Take off highlight execution, enable them, run them, they're all enabled. Perfect. Going back to test.vi, I need to do essentially the same thing in two places, disabling here and enabling here. Rather than make a copy of this block of code twice, we know that this is a perfect case for a sub-VI, so I'll make this new VI into a sub-VI. To be able to control whether I enable or disable, I'll pull this constant outside of the loop, and also create an error cluster going in. And going out. wire these back up, and disable indexing because I don't want to have an array of error clusters. This is the section I want to make into a sub-VI, so I'll just select it and go to Edit, Create Sub-VI. I'll look at the block diagram of this new sub-VI. Let's clean it up with a block diagram cleanup. And I have this array of incoming references, which corresponds to an array of refnums, or reference numbers, on the front panel. This accepts an array of incoming references from a calling VI. Let's save this. I'll call it disable, and give it a nice icon. There's a glyph already waiting for me. Lovely. Now I can drop disable VI in place of these existing property nodes and connect everything. But first we'll fix the connector pane. To the 4x2x2x4. Back on test VI, I'll make this array of references. Simply copy this and now I'll see that my test VI behaves exactly as it did before. I can run it, edit these controls. When I click on Run Test, the test is running, and I can't edit these controls until the test is finished and they've been re-enabled. Disable VI is now a very handy sub-VI to be able to use in future applications. We'll take a look at that in Part B of this video.